Welcome to my world. Won't you come on in? Miracles, I guess, still happen now and then. Step into my heart, leave your cares behind. Welcome to my world, built with you in mind. Knock and the door will open. Seek and you will find. Ask and you'll be given the key to this world of mine. I'll be waiting here with my arms unfurled.
South of the border, hey, I know a lad. He's got more fun than anybody's had. Don't got no worry, don't got no dough. Everybody's wondering about Mexican Joe. In old Mexico, they call him the Rumba King. Leads all the women around on a string. When they go out, they get a million thrills. But the lovely senoritas wind up with the bills. Dancing, romancing, always on the go. Sun shining down on Mexican Joe.
Folks, good evening. We're happy to see you. Happy because we know you will look back on tonight as the turning point in your lives. My cohort and I are privileged to offer for the first time on the African continent the miracle drink of the age, Dr. Nature's Cure-All.
Not just another medicine, folks, but a miracle drink. Blended and distilled from secret remedies and herbs known only to the ancient American Indian.
Nature's way of restoring health and vigor and ridding you of all pain and suffering.
Will it get rid of my mother-in-law?
That'll take two bottles, friend. Then just open the door and stand aside.
Will it grow hair on my head?
Oh, it'll grow a beard on your wife, sir. So careful how she uses it.
Worth more than all your diamonds in Kimberley, ladies and gentlemen. And what will it cost you?
£10 a bottle?
No, sir.
£1.
Not even that, ladies and gentlemen. This priceless boon to mankind is available to you at only 2 shillings a bottle.
Now, don't rush, folks. There's plenty here for everybody.
Madam, take 2 bottles
Thank
in case you miss
Thank
us you the next time. Thank you very much. How about you, madam?
Anybody else?
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. You'll not regret it, I'm sure.
Hey, ma'am, what about you?
Do you think it's all right for my face?
Oh, it'll work on a pineapple, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yes, lady.
Any more over here?
One here. You'll ever see in your entire life. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Don't thank us, friends. It's been our privilege.
Well, I never thought we'd come to this.
What are you complaining about? It's a nice, unhealthy town. How much is that for the day?
Oh, about £15.
What's that in money?
$75.
Jerry.
Yeah?
You been at the customers again?
Now, why say that, Jim? Hey, Jim, you know I wouldn't do a thing like that.
How many times have I told you no more pickpocketing?
I'm sorry, I couldn't miss the opportunity. There they were.
You remember what happened to us in the Klondike and St. Louis and Frisco?
Yeah, but our luck was running bad then, Jim.
What makes you think it's running any better? The wallet's empty.
I'm sorry, you're trying to make a fatter roll for a big killing tonight.
$75 will be enough for that. You just be sure and deal me 4 aces. Those low penalties don't always come off.
A man wants 4 aces, he'll get 4 aces. See you later, huh?
double.
I'll see that.
I'm over here.
Oh, well.
I'll see that.
Flush, king high.
Seems to be your lucky evening.
I only hope it stays that way.
Cut.
Away.
I'll play. Me too. Cards. Three.
Two.
None for me.
Dealer takes one. I'm out.
Double.
Redouble, gentlemen.
I'll see that.
How much is that?
£60, I believe.
Redouble.
I should very much like to match your stakes, gentlemen, but as you can see, I'm running short of ready cash. However, I do have a gold watch, if you will accept that, worth considerably more than £60.
It's all right with me.
Okay with me.
Your call.
Double.
Redouble.
Hurry, get the boss.
You staying with us?
How much is that now, gentlemen?
240, I make it. Hmm.
I'm afraid I really should see you, gentlemen, but as you realize, I don't have the cash.
Why don't you throw in now?
Look, gentlemen, I have the papers of my diamond claim worth at least £240. Would you accept that?
How come you got a diamond claim and no cash? It doesn't figure.
Well, it just doesn't happen to be producing at the moment, but it will in a day or so.
Wouldn't like to see you lose your diamond claim.
I have not yet lost, gentlemen. If you will accept the papers...
It's all right with me, if it's all right with you.
It's okay with me. I'm away anyway.
What you got?
Four kings.
Four aces.
Oh, tough luck.
Oh, that's quite all right. Looked like a good hand. Thank you for the game, gentlemen. If you will excuse me, please. Thank you.
Yes, well, thanks, gents. It's... been a lot of fun. We'll probably see you tomorrow night.
Right. Oh, well, we're back with you. Sure.
Well, I hope you get the opportunity.
These are our two, Mr. Bradley.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Hi.
Good evening.
You gentlemen had a successful game?
Yes, thank you very much. Matter of fact, we were just leaving.
Well, just before you do, would you mind placing your winnings on the table?
What for?
What's the idea?
The idea is simply this. We don't approve of your Mississippi habits here. I run a reputable establishment, and my clientele rely on me to see that there are no card sharps about.
Card sharps? Dirty Jake!
You want to watch what you're saying?
I've been watching you. What are these?
Let's tar and feather them.
Oh, hi, Macy.
Let's get going, lover boy.
Oh, yeah. Well, so long, Macy. Nice knowing
you. Guys all night.
Morning. Hey, Jerry. Ain't that the fellow we played poker with last night?
You mean the old geezer we cleaned out?
Yeah. Say, where you headed for, friend?
I beg your pardon. Oh, it's you, gentlemen. I'm on my way to Mac.
Who's he?
Mac. Oh, that's the town where my... where your claim is.
Well, how far is this place, Mac? Mac?
Oh, it's about another 40 miles, I should say.
It's a long walk.
Well, after last night, I'm afraid that's all I can afford.
Well, we seem to be heading your direction. Hop in.
Oh, thank you very much.
My name is Jim Madison.
How do you do?
And this is my friend, Jerry Bates.
How do you do? I'm Albert Patterson. Of course, everybody calls me Bert.
Hiya, Pop.
You visit Kimberley often?
No, not more than two or three times a year. Of course, I only went down this time to try and raise some money for the claim.
Pogo was the wrong way to try that.
Yes, well, I simply don't know what Julie's going to say when she hears about this. You see, the claim was all we had. And if she hears I've been gambling again, well,
Julie, is she your wife?
No, she's my daughter.
Your daughter, huh?
Yes. Do you know she even took a job singing at the Mac Hotel, just to keep us going?
Well, you are in a tough spot. Tell you what, you just hang on to the papers.
Hey, what are you doing?
Thank you very much, but I wouldn't dream of doing such a thing. It was a debt of honor, and you won it fairly and squarely.
Sure, we won it fair and square. This diamond claim might be worth a gold mine to us.
All right, tell you what, Bert, any time you can raise the 240 pounds, the papers are yours.
That's very generous of you.
But you can't have your watch back. I've got too many of them anyway.
Oh, thank you very much. I'd appreciate it greatly borrowing this for a while.
Well, Jerry, let's get on over and take a look at that diamond claim, huh?
Mac, here we come.
What brought you to Africa?
Getting kind of crowded back home. A man couldn't make an honest living any longer.
Making a living's difficult anywhere.
Cheer up, Pop, your luck will break.
Well, I just wasn't born to be lucky.
I'd like to be the picture on your mantel. I'd like to be the window in your door. I'd like to be the feather on your pillow. I'd even like to be the carpet on your floor. I'd like to be the star outside your window. That lucky chair that holds you every night. The coffee pot you warm up every morning. I'd even like to be the apple that you bite. And if you need someone to talk with, I'd like to be the little voice inside. And if you ever have a heartache, I want to be the tear you hide. I'd like to be the record on your phonograph, the melody that haunts you night and day. And when you're old enough to want to marry, I'd like to be the one who steals your heart away.
Now, which one of you in the class can tell me the names of Van Riebeek's three ships?
The Dromedaris, Reiter,
and Dakumakar.
Morning, ma'am.
Back to your desks, children. Back to your desks.
Good morning, Rube.
Hello, Bert.
Will you bring the gentleman's luggage in, please?
Yeah, sure.
Glad to see you found some partners, Bert.
Not exactly, Max. I'll explain when I see you later.
Okay, later.
Hello, Punchy.
Morning, Miss Patterson.
These gentlemen want to book in.
Sign, yeah.
Good morning, gentlemen. I see you back, Patterson.
Yes.
How did you make out in Kimberley?
Well, to be quite truthful, that's a very good question. Meet Mr. Madison, Mr. Bates, Mr. Forster. He owns the hotel and the liquor store.
I take it you're Mr. Patterson's new partners?
More or less.
Good. Then you'll be able to pay what's owing on the water account. I was looking it up only this morning. It's more than £80, you know.
What's he talking about, Pop?
Well, you see, Mr. Forster also owns the district water supply, and as you might have gathered, my account has been running up a little bit just lately.
And the way I hear it's going on your claim, no more water until the account's settled. I'm sorry.
Oh, boy, there's one like this in every town.
Well, now that we're Mr. Patterson's partners, there's nothing to worry about. It's as good as in the bank.
I'd prefer to have it right now, if you gentlemen don't mind.
Yeah, well, since you put it that way, Jerry, pay the man.
What are you doing, Jim? Are you suggesting I should pay this
account? Jerry, our partner owes the man money. Pay him.
Here. You pay him. Why should I feel bad? Come on, Pop, we'll give you a lift to the claim.
Oh, thank you.
Let's go to my office.
Hey, I brought in your bags.
Oh, yeah, sure. Let's see what we got here that we can find for you. How about that? Would you like another one like that?
Yes.
Well, look at my hand. Nothing in it, huh? Abracadabra. What you got in your hand there?
Diamonds.
Oh, just like pieces of glass, huh?
Blue whites, the best they are.
Well, how much would three like that be worth?
50, 60 quid.
Is that a fact?
Yes, and I put all my savings into diamonds.
Well, whenever you want me to carry your bags, just let me know, huh?
Hello, Bert.
Hello, Harvey. Is that what it's called?
Bert!
Would you mind, Jenny, just...
Hold it a minute, will you? Hello, Bert. It's good to see
hello,
you again.
Hello, Fred. Hello.
Have you heard about the price of water?
No, what is it?
That jackal Forster put it up again by another shilling.
Oh, no. He didn't tell me about it. I only saw him a couple of minutes ago.
3 shillings for 40 gallons now.
Oh, no.
And we're not going to stand for that.
Well, of course not.
Now, I called a meeting tonight at the hotel for 8:30.
Good.
I want all the diamond diggers committee there.
Uh-huh.
So be sure you're there, Bert.
I'll be there. Don't you worry, Fred.
Okay. Cheerio,
bye-bye,
Bert.
Fred.
Bye-bye, gentlemen.
Bye-bye, Jerry.
So long. Which is your claim, Bert?
Oh, it's away from the main diamond fields, about a mile further on.
We are Cairo, Chica. We are Cairo.
Do you think there's going to be a fight at the meeting tonight, Danny?
Usually ends up that way, Neil.
Then I'm not going to school tonight.
Hello, Danny.
Hello, Mr. Patterson.
Struck anything yet?
No, not a thing.
How are the washes looking? Better?
Much the same as they were.
Oh, this is Danny Pretorius, my assistant.
How
John
are you,
Anderson,
Danny?
Jerry Bates.
Hi, Danny.
How do you do?
And Jonas here is my boss boy.
Hello, Jonas.
Hey, sir.
This is Niels. He transports water for us.
Hiya, Niels.
Gosh, Mr. Patterson, did you buy this from Kimberley?
No, Niels. It belongs to these gentlemen. They're from overseas.
My father's overseas, too. You think he's also got one like this?
He sure has. A rich man like him. Maybe he has, too.
Hello, Dad.
Hello, my dear. My daughter, Julie.
Well, so you're Julie?
Yes.
Oh, well, hi, I'm Jerry.
Hello.
Oh, and this here's Jim Madison and Mr. Patterson. Of course, he's your father.
Hello, Julie. Your dad's told us a lot about you.
Trust Dad. You got back quickly. Everything go all right?
Well, there is something I have to tell you. You see,
Dad?
Oh,
well,
what he's trying to say is that we're partners now, 50-50, right down the middle, huh?
That's right. We have the money. You people have the experience. It's a natural.
Well, that's wonderful. Just in time, too. We were beginning to run out of supplies.
Don't you worry about that, Julie. That's our concern from now on.
Yeah.
Danny, Niels, lunch is ready.
Well, I'll show you around the place after lunch.
Well, I can see right now. I'm going to like it just fine here.
Good.
I'm sure you will.
Yes. Of course, everyone in the district said we were crazy when we took over this claim.
Well, the way I see it, you haven't proved them wrong yet, Pop.
But we will. You wait and see. Just another few days and we'll strike the rich gravel, eh, Danny?
You're a great cook, Julie.
Thank you.
She's more than that. If it weren't for Julie taking their job at the hotel, we'd have had to stop eating quite a long time ago.
Oh, I enjoy singing anyway. You know that, Dad.
Yes, but Danny and I would rather you didn't have to work for that jackal Forster.
You don't have to do that any longer now that we're here, Julie.
Oh, I wouldn't stop now, just because you've got partners.
No, I don't think you should either. Not until I've heard you sing, anyway.
You might be disappointed.
Well, if you can sing like you can cook, there's not much chance of that.
Well, we'd better get back, Niels. Thanks for the lunch, Julie.
Thanks, Julie.
Oh, by the way, Mr. Patterson, I told the boys on the claim that they'd get their back pay as soon as you returned from Kimberley.
Heavens, yes. It must be at least 4 weeks since they were last paid.
What does that come to?
I don't know. Julie keeps the books. How much is it, dear?
£45.
Better give it to Danny now, Jerry.
Sure.
Very kind of you, I'm sure.
Happy to help out, Bert.
And Mr. Forster said no more water unless we pay cash, Mr. Patterson.
I know.
Is this enough for you, Nielsey boy?
Thanks, Mr. Bates.
Well, anything else while the money's out?
Yes, well, of course, Danny and Niels and Jonas haven't been paid all this time either.
Yes, and you'll need money for supplies. What does all that come to, Julie?
£50 should be enough.
Jerry?
Sure cost a fortune to make money. 10, 20, 30, 40.
Hello, Fred.
Evening.
Hello, John.
Hello there. Over here, Fred.
Evening.
Looks like the diggers committee are hatching up some sort of a plot, huh, Danny?
I don't think there's much they can do about it. Ben Forster controls all the water in this district.
Why don't you guys try digging for some?
We have. Some are trying even now, but this is a dry area. Not easy to find water.
Speak it out tonight, Droop.
Yeah, I don't think they're here to enjoy themselves. Take a look at that committee.
It's a damn good idea, and I'll drink to it.
I better go and tell the boss there's going to be trouble tonight.
Isn't the liquor store coming up?
Please help me, I'm falling in love with you. Close the
Goodness, it's good to see you.
How are you, Bert?
Oh, fine. Oh, this is a surprise. We weren't expecting you for quite a while yet.
Got 3 months off for good behavior.
Oh, it's good to have you back.
Julie's grown into a fine young woman, Bert.
Ah, she's a wonderful girl. But wait till you see your Niels. You'll never recognize him. That tall.
Does he know about me, Bert?
Well, somehow we never did tell him. As a matter of fact, he thinks you're overseas. That was Jonas's idea. You remember Jonas?
Yes. Is he still with you?
Yes, one of the family. He and Niels are great friends.
Overseas, huh?
Niels is an intelligent lad. He'll understand. Of course, he won't know you to start off with. 6 years is a long time in a boy's life.
Yes. I doubt if I'd recognize him myself.
You know, he should be having a lesson with Elise right now, if you care to stroll over to the schoolhouse. We're having a bit of a meeting over here. Otherwise, I'd come along.
Thank you, Bert. I appreciate everything that you've done for Niels.
Oh, not at all. Now, look, the school is just past the market. You can't miss it. I'll see you later.
But tonight's a big meeting, Mr. Bert. And Danny said there might be trouble.
All the more reason why you shouldn't be here. Now, come along.
But there's going to be a fight. I know it.
There will be if you don't come to school now, Niels. Now, come along.
Oh, gee,
excuse me. I don't mean to interfere, but isn't it getting rather late for school?
Yes, in fact, far too late. But it's the only time I can get in there. Come along, Niels.
I'm Jan Leroux. I'm a friend of Bert Patterson.
My name's also Leroux.
Yes, Mr. Patterson has told me all about you, Niels.
Well, good night, sir.
Good night, sir.
You know, Niels, I think Mr. Leroux's right. It is rather late for lessons.
Does that mean I can stay?
You might as well.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Bear.
Friends, time to get out of business. Now, you all know why we're here tonight. To settle this matter of the price of water. 3 shillings for 40 gallons, according to Mr. Ben Forster. Well, he's making it impossible for us to carry on, even to earn a living. And we're not going to stand for that, are we? I say the time has come to do something about it. To force him to bring down the price of water by at least half. Now, Forster, you've heard what we had to say about this. For the last time, we're asking you, bring down the price of water.
3 shillings for 40 gallons isn't unreasonable.
And we say that half that price is plenty.
I have my expenses. Do you expect me to run my business at a loss?
No, nor do we expect you to skin us alive.
You're profiteering, that's what you're doing. Yeah.
No one tells me how to run my business. Either take it at the price or stay without water.
Listen, everybody, quieten down. Quieten down. Well, we knew what he'd have to say. Now, you listen to me, Foster. We can't do without water, that's true. But we can do without your hotel and the liquor store. So what I say is this, friends. Unless Ben Foster agrees to reduce the price of water immediately, we boycott his hotel and the liquor store until he does.
Go ahead. We'll see who holds out the longest.
There's your answer, friends. Now, are we all together in this boycott?
Yes.
Right. Come on, everybody. Let's get out of here.
You're coming.
Where to? We live here.
Oh, yes. Good night.
So, here you are. Don't you know there's a boycott on? Sitting
come
here,
on,
drinking.
You've had enough. No more
come
drinking.
Get you home. Where's the boy? Don't you ever have enough?
Come along, Niels.
Isn't there going to be a fight, Danny?
No, we're having a boycott instead.
Oh, good night, Mr. Bell.
Good night, Niels.
Good night.
Good night. He's bright at his lesson.
Ah, here you are.
Hello, Elise.
Oh, hello, Bert.
Well, what did Niels have to say?
Well, I haven't had the opportunity to tell him, Bert.
Oh, well, you'll have plenty of time to do that. Now, you're coming to stay with us. We've been keeping a bed for you.
Thank you, Bert. But I think I'll just...
No, no, you're none of that. You're staying with us. Besides, you can't stay here. We're boycotting the ruddy place.
Then what are you still doing here, Patterson? If you're going to boycott me, why don't you get out and join your friends?
Come on, let's go.
Come on, come on. Off the veranda. Get going. Hey.
Hit him, Mr. LaRue.
Come on. Have a go. Scared, eh?
Cut it out now. Punch it.
Stay out of this.
Come on.
Danny, wait.
Come on, Danny. Hit him.
Come on, harder. Harder, Punchy. Harder, man. Punchy. For Punchy, yes. Hit him.
That's a stop, Danny.
Stop him. Stop this. Stop this fighting. You're acting like a lot of savages.
Come on, let him fight on, Julie.
No. No more fighting, Danny, please. You leave him alone, Punchy.
Give us our money back, Mac.
No, just a minute. Wait a minute. I'll just hold everything. Wait a minute.
Julie's quite right. This is no way to have a fight, like a couple of wild animals. I tell you what we'll do. We'll arrange a proper boxing match between Danny and Punchy for next Saturday night with a ring and a referee and everything. Okay, Danny, Punchy, is that okay with you for next Saturday night?
Anytime he likes, Max.
That's fine with me.
All right, there you are, friends. Next Saturday night, a proper boxing match. And I'm open to take bets at any time, and I'll give you the best odds in town. Who wants to make a bet? What's your bet?
Come on, Danny.
You'd better follow us home, man.
Right, Bert.
You all right, Danny?
Yeah, fine.
You would have won if they hadn't stopped you, Danny. I knew there was going to be a fight.
Bloodthirsty little blighter.
And you know what, Jonas? Umyon didn't even want to hit Punchy back. He seemed to be frightened.
Maybe he don't like fighting.
No, you could see that he was scared. So Danny ran up and wham! Stop pushing right in his face.
You should be at school getting clever, not wasting time on fights.
But Eunice, you should have seen it. Wham! Bang! Danny was hitting Punchy. They were both rolling over.
Niels.
The people were cheering for Danny and Danny was hitting Punchy.
Niels.
Yes, Danny?
You better run over and get some more water before we run dry.
Anything you say, Danny.
Hi, fellas.
That must be Jerry. Morning, Jerry.
Hi, Julie. How's our nightingale this morning? I just stopped by to tell you I wasn't disappointed last night. I think you can sing even better than you can cook.
Thank you kindly, sir.
Now, what do we do today? Take a ride to the sea, climb a mountain, maybe swim a river? Anything your heart desires, just say the word.
You can take me to the village to buy supplies.
Jerry Bates and his chariot at your service.
I'll get my list. Come in.
Oh, hi, Bert.
Good morning, Jerry. This is an old friend of mine, Jan LaRue. Jerry Bates.
How do you do?
Glad to know you,
eh? Where's Jim?
Oh, he stayed in town. He had some important business to finish off.
Jerry's just taking me to town for supplies, Dad.
Oh, Jerry, by the way, I forgot to mention this to you yesterday. We need some money for the machinery on the claim. Still owe some money on it.
Oh, sure. How much do you need?
£45. And I'm afraid we have to pay it by tomorrow morning. They're threatening to take it away.
Oh, I'll let you have it. I don't carry that much on me right now.
Thank you.
So long.
Goodbye.
Back about 1800 and some, a Louisiana couple had a red-headed son. No name suited him, Jim, Jack, or Joe. They just called him Billy Bio. Billy, Billy Bio, watch where you go. You're walking on quicksand, walk slow. Billy, Billy Bio, watch what you say. A pretty girl will get you one of these days. Billy was a boy kind of big for his size, red hair and freckles and big blue eyes. 13 years from the day he was born, Bill fought the battle of the Little Big Horn. Billy, Billy Bio, watch where you go. You're walking on quicksand, walk slow. Billy, Billy Bio, watch what you say. A pretty girl will get you one of these days. One sad day, Billy cried, ho, ho, I can whip the feathers off a Geronimo. He smarted off, the chief got mad, this nearly ended our Louisiana lad. Billy, Billy Bio, watch where you go, you're walking on quicksand, walk slow. Billy, Billy Bio, watch what you say, a pretty girl will get you one of these days. One day in 1878, a pretty girl walked through Bill's front gate.
Had some important business to finish off, huh?
Well, that's what he said.
Thank you, Mr. Madison. That was a lovely singing lesson. Maybe you'll sing again tonight for us at the Ticky Dry.
Ticky Dry? Where's that?
Children, Ticky Dry is our version of a barn dance.
Do you have them here, too?
Yes, all the time, but especially during boycotts.
Yeah, that might be fun. See you tonight at the Ticket Dry, kids, okay?
Okay, yes, Mr. Madison!
Aren't you guys going over to the barn dance?
No, we've got a poker game arranged.
Oh, you play poker?
Small game.
Well, I play a little myself. Maybe Jim and I'll drop by later for a few hands.
Yes, do that, do that. Through your fingers.
I hear the sound of distant drums
there all the time we can before it's too late. Love me now, for now is all the time there may be. If you I hear the sound of bugles blow far away, far away. And if they call, then I must go.
You must have been overseas a long time for your son not to recognize you.
You don't really believe this overseas story, do you?
Why shouldn't I? That's what Neil's always told us.
He was only told that to cover the truth. I was in jail for 6 years for killing a man. It was foolish, really. And it started off from nothing. Like this thing with Punchy last night. All of a sudden there was a fight and I hit him. He fell and knocked his head against a rock and he died. It's as simple as that.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
That's all right, Elise. I'm glad I told you.
There's a lovely blue-white sparkler in your eye, dear Maisie, sparkling like the bubbles in the rye. I've been digging around for fortunes, and I don't mean maybe, just to find that pothole in your eye. There's a deuce of a lot of rushing going on, dear Maisie, for that precious sparkler in your eye. I'll be knocking at your window if you're not too cagey about that pretty sparkler in your eye. Until I die.
Until he dies.
Until I die.
Until he dies. He's gonna stake that claim of love light in your eye. He's quitting pick and shovel and his shady looking hovel for...
Hey, Ben!
That diamond-studded promise in your eye.
I'll see that. Trip tent. Too good for me. Seems to be your lucky evening, huh?
You need more than luck to win at poker.
Cut.
Mind if I reshuffle?
I'll play.
Right.
Play. Cards.
Two cards, please.
Two here.
None for me.
Dealer takes one.
I'm out.
Double.
Redouble.
I'll raise that. How much is that?
£20.
Double.
Redouble.
Oh, boy, £80. That's too much for me.
How much you got there, Jerry?
£10.
What's wrong, Mr. Madison? Can't you match my stake?
It's not enough. How about those watches? I'm 15 shy. Would you accept these watches?
Right, and you seeing me?
No, I redouble.
Then put in your stake.
I thought you might trust me for that.
No, sir, I never play poker on the account.
How about the automobile? Will you accept that as collateral?
£160, yes, accepted.
Right.
And I've redoubled.
I'll see that.
What are you boys going to do for transport from now on? Four kings.
Four aces.
Hold it. You don't seem to have seen my hand, Mr. Madison.
I saw your hand. You have four kings and I have four aces.
Rube, tell the gentleman what happens here on Thursday night.
Thursday night? Oh, yeah. Thursday night, kings are wild.
What do you mean, kings are wild?
And even if they are wild, they don't beat aces.
When kings are wild, they beat anything.
You could have told us they were wild before we started.
I thought you knew the rules in this town.
When you're in Rome, you do like the Mac Majesty.
Well, just about wipes us out.
I'm sorry, gentlemen, but that's the way it goes. However, whenever you have £160 in cash, you can have your car back, all right?
Thanks. For nothing.
Sleep well, gentlemen. Thank you.
Kings are wild. How about that?
You know what, Jim? That guy is nothing but a dirty crook.
You wouldn't kid me, would you?
Kings are wild. What do you know about that?
We certainly got taken for a couple of suckers last night.
Suckers or not, we better do something. We're flat broke.
Well, we're more than that. We still owe money on Bert's machinery.
Have to start brewing another batch of Dr. Nature's cure-all, I guess.
Oh, no, not that again.
What do you suggest we do to raise some money?
Well, I've seen a nice couple of wallets around. Fat, I could just...
No more pickpocketing.
Okay, then. We'll starve. Hey, I got a great idea.
Whatever it is, forget it. Every time you get an idea, we lose half our baggage getting out of town.
No, but this is a great idea, Jim. You know, this boycott of the hotel's got Ben Foster really worried. Well, if we can convince him that we can break the boycott, it should be worth something to us.
What do you suggest we do? Hit a few guys on the head and drag them in?
Well, it's just about it. I know just what to use for a club. You leave this to me. If Ben Foster doesn't fall for this, then I'm a gorilla.
Keep shaving, boy. You got a long way to go.
Well, how are you gentlemen feeling this bright and sunny morning? Why are you all looking so miserable?
Nothing.
I know what it is. It's the boycott. You must be losing a fortune in sales there, Ben.
They'll be back soon enough.
Oh, sure they will, but why wait that long when there's a very simple plan to get them streaming right back in here anytime you want?
What simple plan?
Well, I've been thinking about it, and what I think is you want to brighten the place up a little bit. You know, girls, music, dancing, entertainment's what they want, Ben.
I give them entertainment.
No, that's not what I mean. I mean, you want to think big. You know, something real flashy. Now, I think Jim and I are the kind of people that could lay that on for you. The way it happens is this. You lend us our car, we go into Kimberley, pick up the girls and the musicians, come back here. Tomorrow night, we've got the show on, and presto, the boycott is bust.
What makes you think it'll work?
Ben, have you ever known a pretty ankle not to work?
Yeah, but this sounds like it's going to cost me money.
No, not as much as you think. The show won't cost you much. And you can have Jim and I's services for only £100.
£100? Don't be ridiculous.
But that's only part of the money you won off us last night, Ben.
Do you think you could get Julie back?
Well, that's not going to be easy.
If get Julie back, you can have your £100.
Well, I have got some influence there. Now, I think that's a deal, Ben. Oh, just one thing. I'll need £50 in advance.
What for?
Well, you know, Jim and I got cleaned out last night. We need some operating expenses.
Right. But make sure the show goes on tomorrow night with Julie, or you'll have a couple of bad friends around here.
Don't you worry, Ben. The boycott's as good as bust.
50.
Thank you.
Morning, Mr. LaRue.
Morning, Niels.
Hello, Jonas.
Hello, Niels.
What's going on down there, Niels?
Mr. LaRue has started digging.
What makes him think he's going to find diamonds around here?
Mr. Patterson chose that claim for him.
Tell me, do you think Mr. Patterson knows what a diamond looks like? 20, 30, 40, 45, that's right, huh?
That's it. And just in time. I'll tell you something. If I hadn't got this money, I was loading that machinery. Good day.
Hold on. Look, Jerry. I appreciate the trouble you've gone to get this money, but I'm not going to permit Julie to take part in this Break the Boycott show.
Zacharias, load that machinery.
Now look, Bert, I told you, if there's no Julie, there's no show, and then you gotta give this money back to Ben Foster and you'll lose your machinery.
It's true, I suppose. We can't possibly work without machinery.
Unload the machinery, Zacharias.
Mr. Patterson, don't forget you're on the diggers' committee, and I don't think it'll look right for Julie to be taking part in the show.
Zacharias, load the machinery.
Then what do you suggest we do? Work without machinery?
But what'll the people think of us, Julie?
Look, Jerry and Jim have done everything they can to keep this claim going. And I don't think we should worry about people now.
Well, that settles it then, huh?
Well, it seems though we have no ruddy option, does it?
Zacharias, leave the machinery alone. Thank you. Good day.
Oh, cheer up, Pop. So we're paying a little more for water. At least we're keeping the claim going.
Yes. Come on, Danny.
So now what happens is this, Julie. Jim won't be back until tonight from Kimberley with the girls and the musicians. Then we rehearse all day to get the show lined up. Comes 8 o'clock and bang, the big send-off.
If it's for free, it can't affect the boycott, huh?
Sure, if it's for nothing, it can't hurt.
Well, come on, let's go.
Hey, you can't do that. A boycott's a boycott.
Don't have to pay, it doesn't count.
That's the stuff, Willie. Drink up.
Sure, there's no harm in having a drink.
Come along, friends. Anything you want. Beer, brandy, whiskey.
Might as well drink Foster's liquor. Let's go.
That's the stuff. Don't be shy.
Come right in. That's the stuff, boys.
The show is for free. Take a look at those girls.
Everybody's wondering about Mexican Joe. In old Mexico, they call him the Rumba King. Leads all the women around on a string. When they go out, they get a million thrills. But the lovely senoritas wind up with the bills. Dancing, romancing, always on the go. Sun shining down on Mexican Joe. See him when he comes their way. He spreads so much joy everywhere he goes. Everyone shouts, Viva la Mexican Joe. He likes to gamble. At poker, he's an ace. He's always lucky with the cards that got a face. At winning the money, he is sure a whiz. But when they win, they don't collect, cause they don't know where he is. Dancing, romancing, always on the go. Sun shining down on Mexican Joe.
Jim, and thank you, friends. Welcome to the opening of the Diamond Field Follies.
Yay!
I want to announce that I'm putting up a purse of £100, which will go to the winner of the big boxing match between Punchy and Danny on Saturday night.
Yay! Yay!
This boy's gonna kill him tonight.
Yeah, he looks in great shape. Hey, let's try this room. You take a card, anyone. Now, don't tell me what you got will you?
No, I won't.
It's the King of Diamonds.
Yeah, you're right. That's fantastic.
Managed to raise £50 from Foster. Go over and put it on Danny.
What do you mean, Danny? Look at this boy. He's in great shape.
Have you heard the odds Max has given? Punch is only even money. Danny's 5-1. This is our only chance to buy the automobile back.
Well, there goes our automobile.
Danny's no walkover. Now stop arguing and go on over to Max.
Okay, after all, it's only money.
I'm laying 5-1, Danny. Even Punchy, what do you want, lady?
I want 5 on Punchy.
You got a great bet there, lady. What's your next one?
5 on Punchy, please.
You want 5 on Punchy, right? 5 on Punchy. You got
50 on Punchy, Max.
50 on Punchy. Just 1 minute, 50 on Punchy, and there you are. You got a very great bet there, fellow.
Sure hope you're right.
10 on Danny.
Ladies and gentlemen! Ladies and gentlemen! This will be a contest, according to the Queensbury rules, over 10 rounds, for the championship of Mac and a purse of £100. On my left, at £165, the challenger for the Mac crown, Danny Pretorius. And on my right, at £170, the champion of Mac, Punchy Alfred.
Now, look, you've got 10 rounds, Danny. So take it easy to start off with. Let him wear himself out. And look out for that left hook of his. It's dynamite.
Don't be too disappointed if Danny doesn't come through, huh?
What makes you think he won't?
Oh, I didn't mean that, but it's going to be tough going against Punchy.
Now, listen, fellas. No rabbit punches. No low punches. When I say break, break clean, okay? Right.
Seconds out, round one.
Get in!
away from him, Danny. You're no match for him in the infighting.
Get him closer. That's where you can do the most damage. He's got the reach. Keep going for the body.
Seconds out, round two.
If he goes to work on this, it could be dangerous. Now stay away from him this round and cover up all you can.
He's got to stay away from Punchy. He'll close that eye of his.
Keep going for that cut above his left eye. Just get in there and keep going for it, you understand? You're doing fine, Punchy.
Seconds out. Round three.
Great round, huh, Julie?
Yes, looks like your man's winning, doesn't it?
How do you feel, Danny?
All right.
We'd better throw in the towel.
Oh, no, Mr. Patterson, Danny will beat him.
Danny, are you all right?
Hello, Julie.
Danny, I don't think you should go on fighting.
I'm fine, Julie.
Well, it's this round or never.
Danny?
Seconds out. I'm round fine, four. Julie.
Box on.
Thing.
You didn't, and now you've just cost me £100 for not listening.
Punchy, what het gebeur, man?
Ladies and gentlemen, the purse of £100 to the winner, the new champion of Mac Mac, Danny Pretorius.
told you to put the money on Danny, but no, you're much too clever for that.
Well, I'm sorry. I didn't think Punchy could lose.
It cost us £250 for you to find that out. Do you realize that's $1,250?
Well, I said I'm sorry. What more do you want me to do?
Nothing. You've done enough.
Well, calm down, Jim. We've been in worse spots than this. Why don't you relax and let's take stock of the situation?
Well, to begin with, we're flat broke.
Yeah, and Ben Foster's closing the show tonight. That means we're out of a job tomorrow.
No job, no money, no car. We can't even get out of this town.
But we do have a diamond claim.
That's our biggest liability.
Now, what we got to do is to get rid of that claim and get out of here.
That's a good idea, but for one thing, nobody wants it.
Yes, the new Bert Patterson does. You said yourself, any time he could raise the cash, he could have the claim.
Don't make me laugh. Where do you think he's going to raise 240 pounds?
I think I know.
You stop thinking. We're in enough trouble as it is.
Well, look, it's simple. All I got to do is this, Jim.
Don't tell me. I don't think I could stand another one. All I want to think about is getting out of this town.
Well, you leave it to me. This is a great idea, and nothing's going to go wrong.
Here we go again.
Hi, Rube.
Hi, Jerry.
Pity about Punchy last night, huh?
Ah, it was a lucky punch.
What do you mean, lucky punch? Where he went wrong was in the infighting. He didn't get in there close where he could do the damage.
But he was in close. We told him to.
Well, he didn't do it right. Now, let me show you. Put them diamonds away. You see, Punchy didn't seem to have the reach to... Hold this. I'll show you. He didn't get in like this with the kidneys. All right, he was leaning on him, but he wasn't getting in close. And then when the boy least expected it, he stepped back and wham! The fight's over.
You think so?
Sure.
I'm still Punchy that for the return fight.
Thanks, Jerry boy.
It's a funny thing. You'd imagine with all this gravel that you'd find something.
Oh, I'm sure we will, as soon as we get a little deeper.
You sure the diamonds aren't getting lost in here?
Oh, no, that's impossible. You see, what happens...
Oh, yeah,
when
sure.
They...
Sure, Pop, I was only kidding. What I really came over to tell you was that Jim and I are pulling out tomorrow.
Why, what's wrong?
Well, we figure that the show's over. We might as well be moving on.
But what about the claim?
Well, it's what I came to speak to you about. We thought maybe you could raise the 240 and pay us out.
I'm afraid I could never raise that amount by tomorrow morning.
Then you'll have to carry on without us, Pop. I'm sorry.
But they should start cutting in any time now.
Sure, sure, but we can't wait that long.
Coffee, Dad.
Oh, morning, Julie.
Morning.
I was just telling your dad how Jim and I are going to be pulling out tomorrow morning.
Oh, really? Coffee, Danny.
Well, if you come up with anything new, let us know. We'll be at the hotel.
Yes, Jerry.
So then, Jim, what happens is this. Bert comes rushing up here shouting about the diamonds he's just discovered, and we say, well, isn't that wonderful? But we won't go back on our word, Bert. You just hand over the 240. Bert goes over to Max Bloom. He raises a loan on the strength of the diamonds he's just discovered, and we hand over the papers.
Where do you find time for all these dirty tricks?
Well, there's nothing else to do. Anyway, he owes us the 240.
You could have just sold the diamonds you fingered off Rube.
Now, they weren't worth more than 50 or 60 pounds.
Jim! Jerry! They've started up! They're coming in at last!
Here he comes. Now you remember, Jim. Now let me down. You'll be convincing, huh?
I'm on board, Harry. They've started to arrive. Right after you left, Jerry boy. There they were. Three of them. Three beauties. Of course, they're not very big, but they're real beauties.
And that's real great for you, Pop.
And once they start arriving, they'll just come rolling in.
We're real happy for you, Bert.
But I'm happy for all of us. We're partners, remember? 50-50. Right down the middle, huh?
Well, we were until this morning, Pop, but as I told you, Jim here and I, we're pulling out, so if you'll just pay us out, we'll be moving on.
But we could be rich. All of us, we could be rich.
Yeah, well, that's your good luck, Pop. Now, if you'll just pay us the 240, we'll be pulling out.
Oh, well, of course, I don't have that amount on me at the moment.
No, I'm sure the diamonds aren't worth that much, but maybe we could raise a loan on the strength of them. How about going to see Max Bloom?
Well, we could try.
Yeah, Max Bloom's place. Come on, Pop, let me take you over there.
I can't see our blemish. These are beautiful stones, Bert. Blue white to the core. How much do you want?
240 pounds.
That's a lot of money.
Well, you see, it's this way, Max. My partners have said they'd sell out to me if I could raise the 240 pounds. And now that they've decided to leave, well, I'd like to buy them out.
Soon as you found diamonds, you want to sell out.
Oh, it's an arrangement we already had.
Oh, I see. All right, Bert. If you'll agree to sell me the whole output in future, I'll let you have the 240 pounds.
Oh, that's very nice of you, Max.
Oh, but that's what I'm here for. Everybody's friend, huh? Now, Bert, you take these and keep them. The first diamonds, I'm sure they'll bring you a lot of muzzle, huh?
Oh, thank you.
All right, I'll go and get the money, huh?
Thank you.
Well, here are your papers, Pop, and good luck.
Thank you very much. But I still don't understand why you two want to sell out now that we struck.
Well, you know, a deal's a deal. Fair and square, Pop.
There you are, Jim. There you are. I told you it would work. 240 beautiful smackers. What's the matter with you? You trying to reform all of a sudden or something? You said yourself any time you could get the 240, you could have the papers.
That was a dirty trick. You see how excited the old man was?
Well, we only got back what we put into that hole in the ground anyway. Maybe a lot less.
You know what, Jerry? We're just a couple of heels. No good to anybody.
Well, you want us to get that car out of Hawk or not?
You'd better do that before we mess up a few more people's lives.
Oh, Jerry, I've learned how to do it. Take one.
Oh, some other time, Rube.
Mella, dumella, dumella, dia di dumedi sang. Dumela, 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 dia de dumedi sa.
What the? Bastian! Water! Water! Bastian! Come and see! Water! Niels! Water! Niels, we struck water! Look! Where's your father? Have you seen him?
Who?
Your father, Bastian!
He's over there.
Bastian! 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 Water! Plenty water! Come and see! Bastian! Plenty water! Bastian! I pick and roll out in the water just like that!
Come on, Nils!
There it is! Look! Look at it! You've struck it, Jan! You've struck it!
Why are you sitting here? Come on, come and have a look at the water. It's coming out as big as a tree.
Is he really my father?
Of course he's your father. What's wrong with that? You should be proud of him. He's going to be rich now. Come on, come and have a look at the water.
Lovely wet water. Oh, it's marvelous. Congratulations, Jan, congratulations. Look at that lovely water. Look at it.
Hello there, Niels. You wanted to see me?
Yes, Mr. Madison.
What is it, Niels?
Well, I heard that you were leaving town tomorrow and I'd like to go with you.
Where would you like to go to now?
Wherever you go.
But why?
I don't like staying here anymore.
Has something happened?
Well, you see, my father's back.
From overseas? What's so bad about that?
I didn't know Mr. Rue was my father till Jonas told me everything about him today.
What about him?
He hasn't been overseas. He's been in jail. And besides, he's a coward.
What makes you say that?
I saw it. He didn't even want to eat Punchy back.
That doesn't mean he's a coward. Maybe he just didn't want to make trouble.
No, Mr. Madison. I could see, well, that he was frightened.
Well, everyone's frightened sometime.
Why can't he be like Danny? Danny isn't afraid of anyone.
Just because your father wouldn't hit Punchy back, you want to run away from home?
I thought my father was going to be special.
Everyone's father is special. Just take it easy till you get to know him better.
Does that mean I can't go with you tomorrow, Mr. Madison?
I tell you what, let's just let it rest until tomorrow, huh? Aren't you supposed to be in school tonight?
No, he wants me to go to school during the day, too. Well, thank you, Mr. Madison. Sorry I troubled you.
No trouble at all, Niels. See you in the morning.
Good night, Mr. Madison.
Good night, Niels.
Good evening, Jim.
Oh, hello. Elise, I'm happy you could come.
I overheard what Niels said. You aren't going to take him, are you?
No, I couldn't do that. Did you know about all this?
Yes, John told me.
How long was he in jail?
Over 6 years. He got into a fight, hit a man, and the man died.
Is that the reason he wouldn't hit Punchy?
Must have been.
Well, I'll try to think of something before tomorrow. Shall we go in?
Yes.
Have you ever been lonely? Have you ever been blue? Have you ever loved someone just as I love you? Can't you see I'm sorry?
you see I've changed, dear? Can't you see I've made? Be a little forgiving. Take me back in your heart. How can I go on living now that we're apart? If you knew what I've been through, then you'd know why I ask you, have you ever been lonely? Have you ever been blue?
That's the end of our show. We'll be leaving tomorrow. We'd like to wish all of you goodbye, good luck, and good digging.
Nice and cheap water. High-class water. Only 1/6. Half-price water.
Jonas.
Yes, sir?
Fill up my tank.
Yes, sir.
No one will get water from Foster from now on.
Tells him damn all right.
Gonna lower the price of your water, Mr. Forster?
Well, here's your man, Santa Claus.
Has he told you about the plan yet, Danny?
Oh, sure, I told him, just the way you said. When the kid and his father arrive, you and Danny start needling and goading this LaRue character until he loses his temper and beats the living daylights out of the both of you. Then the kid thinks, well, his father's just about the bravest, strongest man in the whole world and loves him forevermore. Is that right, Santa Claus?
Yeah, except for one thing. You're going with Danny.
Oh, no, not me. This is your idea, not mine.
Well, if I go, the kid'll catch on it's a fake. He's already spoken to me about the whole thing.
Have you told Jan about the plan?
Sure. I spoke to him about the whole thing last night.
Yeah, well, I sure hope you explained to him this is a little bit of play acting for the sake of the kid.
Sure I did.
And that he shouldn't go around knocking anybody's teeth out.
Yeah, that's right.
Yo, when we finish this, can we get out of here, huh?
The minute we're finished.
They shouldn't be long. We passed them on the road.
Well, Danny, how are things going at the diamond claim?
Not so good. Haven't found another since those three yesterday.
Oh, that's real tough. Real tough.
Well, here he comes now.
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
Off with you and make it convincing now.
Good morning, Jan.
Good morning.
Ah, good luck with your water claim. It's better even than diamonds, huh?
Thank you, Mr. Bloom.
And I wish you good luck to learn everything at school, hey, Neely?
Yes, Mr. Bloom.
See, isn't that the Nielsen used to carry water for you, Danny?
Yes, I think it is.
Have you ever seen anything so funny in all your life as those little trousers and that Lord Fauntleroy shirt? Hold it. We gotta be sure this the Nielsen used to carry water for us. He looks like he's going to a girl's party. Oh, not so fast. We haven't had so much fun around here in a long time.
Wait a minute. That's no way to treat my friend. You owe him an apology.
We don't want any trouble, Danny. Just leave us alone. Come on, son.
You didn't hear me. I said apologize.
Listen, Danny.
Well, what are you waiting for?
Come along, son.
Hey, wait a minute. Not so fast. If it's a fight you're looking for, I'm just...
You couldn't fight.
You shouldn't fight unless you have to.
But you knocked down two of them, and Danny's the strongest man in town.
He'll be late for school, son.
Anything you say, Dad.
Hey, Danny, what's going on here? Fighting like that. Such a gavotte.
Hello, Max.
What's happened? Take him to the hotel.
That wasn't a bad fight there, Max.
That Yanni's a fighter. Are you all right, Danny?
Great work, boys. Great. That was fine. That went off beautifully. That was terrific. Danny, that was great. Jerry, that was terrific.
I'm proud of you. I'm proud of both of you.
Gee, Jerry, what a punch. You should have ducked.
Hey, I thought you said you told him about it. That's for real.
Yeah, I guess he forgot.
Yeah, what a friend you turn out to be. A liar. Why, I got a good mind.
Now, hold on, Jerry. Hold on. I can explain everything.
Well, you better. You better make it good, too.
Remember, I told you the last time Jan hit a man, he killed him and went to jail for it. And aside from proving to the boy that he's not a coward, he had to prove that to himself, too. That was more important than impressing the boy. If he'd known about the plan, it wouldn't have meant a thing.
Sounds all right to me, Jerry.
A real regular Santa Claus, ain't you?
Jim, Jerry, I've got wonderful news, Danny.
Whoa there.
Jim, Jerry, it's marvelous.
Come on, darling.
They've started up again, Danny. They're rolling. They've started to come again.
We struck it rich, Danny. We struck it rich. Look at these. 10 beauties in only 3 washes. Look at them, aren't they wonderful? And that one, the size of my thumb.
Yes, it happened right after you left. We just couldn't wait to let you know. Isn't it wonderful?
Gee, that's great, Julie. But you deserve it.
Thanks, Jerry. But we could never have got this far if it hadn't been for you and Jim.
I think nothing of it. We're just a couple of Santas.
What on earth has happened to you two?
Oh, don't worry about us. We were just doing our good deed for the day before pulling up.
But it seems such a pity to miss out right in the end. Are you sure you won't stay? Same deal as before, you know. 50-50 right down the middle.
But a deal's a deal, Pop.
Yeah, it's fair and square, Bert.
But there is one thing before we go. Those 3 diamonds you found yesterday, I sure would appreciate having them just for old time's sake.
Why, certainly, Jerry. Here they are.
Thank you. Just to remind us of the time, we nearly struck it rich.
We better get moving, Jim.
Yeah, I guess we better be going. Goodbye, Julie.
Well, so long,
Goodbye,
Bert.
Jerry.
So long, Danny.
Thank
Good luck
you.
With the claim now.
Thanks, Jerry.
So long,
Jim.
Julie.
Bye-bye, Jerry.
Keep him rolling now, will you? Goodbye.
And you be sure and look after him, huh?
He'll be looking after me from now on.
So long, Rube.
Bye-bye, Jim.
Well, so long, Rube.
Bye-bye, Jerry.
Oh, hang on, fellas, hang on. I won't be long. I'll be right back. I've forgotten something. Almost forgot to say goodbye, Ben. Thanks for everything. It's been a very nice stay.
Cheerio, Jerry.
Oh, and next time we come around, we'll remember that Thursday night kings are wild, eh?
Jerry, just before you go, take one.
Yeah, sure.
Now, you don't tell me what it is.
No, I won't.
That's a king of diamonds.
Well, that's great, Rube. Stick around. We'll make you a partner.
Gee, thanks, Jerry.
Oh, by the way, did you ever find them diamonds you were looking for?
No. And if I find a bloke who stole them off me, I'll kill him. You think so?
Well, go take a look.
You're looking for trouble?
No.
Thanks, Danny.
So long, Bert. Bye, so Julie.
Bye.
Good luck. Hope you also strike it rich someday.
Don't worry, we will.
Adios, amigo. Adios, my friend. The road we have traveled has come to an end. When two love the same love, one love has to lose, and it's you who she longs for, it's you she will choose. Adios, compadre, what must be, remember to name one muchacho for me. I ride to the Rio, where my life I will spend. Adios, amigo. Adios, my friend.